Epstein-Barr virus is something that infects about 80% of the world's population. So almost everyone, when we are growing up during our childhood years or our teenage years, early in life usually, do get exposed to the virus. So we get it, our body's immune system fights it, and most people or vast majority of patients shed it off and nothing really happens, it doesn't phase them. However, it's selected population or a small percentage of patients continue to develop either an immune response to the virus, which leads to complications, or continue to have symptoms, or continue to develop organ-related problems. So these are the patients in whom we suspect that the virus has persisted and a chronic infection is now present. Sometimes the chronic infection is also not present, but there is reactivation of the disease during various stages of life whenever these people go through periods of stress. So when people come in with symptoms of chronic fatigue or symptoms that suggest that maybe a chronic virus infection or Epstein-Barr virus related inflammation is present in the body, a full virus panel is done. And this test consists of four different types of antibodies. So how do we understand what do these antibody titers mean? First of all, not the presence of all of these antibodies is going to mean different things. So we just need to understand that. The first titer is Epstein-Barr virus IgM or viral capsid antigen IgM. So this is the IgM, which is the antibody that is present in the acute phase or in the first few days of developing the infection. And if this IgM antibody, which is to the viral capsid antigen of the virus, is present, then the acute infection or a very recent infection is present, and this person is actually acutely infected and needs to get appropriate treatment. The second type of antibody is the same viral capsid antigen antibody, or the antibody to the viral capsid antigen, but it is IgG antibody. And when IgG antibody to the viral capsid antigen is present, then we say that there is a past infection or remote infection. So this antibody developed over time, and this person was not recently infected, but it was infected at some time in the past. Now, the presence of this antibody actually means nothing if it's the only antibody present. It just means that you got the infection at some time, and most of the time this is not going to cause any problems because 80% of the population has this antibody in their system. The next antibody, unless there are symptoms present for which we need to then do further digging, the next antibody is the nuclear antigen antibody, or the antibody to the Epstein-Barr virus nucleus. When this is present, then also it means that an old infection is there. The infection occurred at some point in the past, and now the patient has ongoing levels or persistent levels of the antibody to the nuclear antigen. Now, the presence of this antibody, again, doesn't necessarily mean that somebody is sick with the virus or infected with the virus, but may mean that there is chronic persistent infection, which means that maybe they have the potential to develop reactivation in future, or if they are sick with symptoms and we can suspect that maybe the reactivation of the virus has occurred and now they need to be supported or treated. Then next, but this antibody to the nuclear antigen does not develop early on in the disease phase. So again, it means remote or old infection. The next antibody is the early the antibody to the early antigen. And when you see the word early antigen, then that is the basically marker, which that is the name that suggests that either a reactivation has occurred or a persistence of the inflammation is there from the infection, or an ongoing infection is present. So this is to be taken seriously because this means that the inflammation in the body is possibly coming from the virus, and we need to go ahead and treat accordingly. Now, a subset of population that has the antibodies to the nuclear antigen or the antibodies to the early antigen and even the IgM antibodies, they will go on to develop something called chronic fatigue syndrome or myalgic encephalomyelitis, or other complications associated with the Epstein-Barr virus inflammation or infection. So they need we need to do further digging and need to treat accordingly. So that is how this set of labs, which can be quite confusing, can be explained to the patients. Thank you.